We've had a very exciting week for file systems on Linux, which is not a statement I thought I or anybody else was going to say. Don't worry, we will be talking about both situations, but for today, let's talk about the one that had a more serious problem attached to its original maintainer, the file system made by a convicted felon specifically for the murder of his wife. I know there are people who think it's funny to be like, oh, Hans Reiser and Kent Overstreet, there's like so many similarities with their stories. Never forget that Hans killed his wife. That is a lot more serious than being mean on the Linux kernel mailing list. So yes, we are talking about ReiserFS, made by the now infamous Hans Reiser. Last month, we saw the creation of ReiserFS, the last commit, which sounds very ominous. Deprecation period of ReiserFS ends with the end of this year, so it is time to remove it from the kernel made by Jankara of SUSE. And just a few days ago, this was merged by Linus Torvalds. Now, I don't see any reason why this would be reverted. Nobody's really using ReiserFS. It hasn't been updated properly in a long time, and no distros make it easy to use. So if all things stay the same, this is going to be dropped in the 6.13 kernel. This is 32,800 lines of code being dropped. It's a lot of code, but it had to happen eventually. Now, this also means the 6.12 kernel, which is likely going to be the next LTS, will be the final supported kernel making use of this file system or having this file system available. That does mean it is going to be available in a supported kernel for a very long time into the future. But again, most people aren't really using it. If you happen to need it, though, for some legacy system, that's what you're going to have to go with. Now, if I'm being honest, I find this project quite fascinating, albeit a little bit morbid, you know, due to the connections with the original developer, who is in prison. I believe in 2027, he has another chance to get parole. So I guess we'll see what happens in 3 years. But for now, let's go back and talk about some of the early history of this project and how we got to the state where it's actually being removed from the kernel. ReiserFS has been around for a very long time, first being introduced into the kernel back in 2001 alongside the 2.4.1 release, released under the GPL v2 license. Now, for most of its life, when it was actually being developed, it was developed under a company called Namesys, founded by Hans Reiser. Quite often, FOSS projects, even if they are made by an individual, will go and make a company, will go and make a non-profit, some form of organization, as this makes it a lot easier to get grants, sponsors, and other sorts of funding, but also to hire people to work on the project as well. It's just easier if there is an official organization to do all the annoying payroll stuff. Now, Namesys didn't just develop the file system, they're also a, I guess, Linux consulting company providing Linux system support as a means to fund development of their main project, that being the file system. They did have sponsors, they did have other funding, but those things come and go, and if someone just suddenly disappears, you don't want to be in a situation where you have way less money and have to fire half your staff. After his arrest under suspicion of murder in 2006, Hans Reiser announced he was planning to sell Namesys as a means to raise money to pay for the ever-growing legal fees. As you might have expected, though, with it being the company that was literally being sold by someone under suspicion of murder, that didn't exactly go too well. According to then Namesys employee Edward Shishkin, this never actually took place. The business ended commercial activity in January of 2008 and as of 2010 is suspended in California. Now, the website for Namesys shut down a little bit earlier than that, the last archive before the shutdown being in 2007. However, you might notice all of this here. So, between 2007 and 2012, nobody owned the domain, at least it didn't seem like anyone did. After that point, though, it's gotten a little bit weird. Clearly, somebody in the Linux world owns the domain and wants to be funny with it. At one point, pointing to the Linux Kernel Archive website. Why? I don't know. I could not tell you. This is how I know somebody in the Linux world owns this domain, because this is a random choice otherwise. At a later point, pointing to a blog, but like this is actually the namesys.com blog. So it's not just pointing to some random other blog. I don't know. And if you go to it today, this is still what it points to. If you know who owns this domain, I would love to know. Now, before its collapse, ReiserFS was actually relatively popular. It wasn't the default on every single Linux distro. However, it was the default on one. It was the default on SUSE Enterprise Linux, and also sponsored by SUSE. Now, that didn't last for that long. In 2006, they swapped over to EXT3. However, not for the reasons you might expect, you know, the whole Hans Reiser thing. SUSE 10.2 ditching ReiserFS as its default file system. This mainly focused on the technical issues of ReiserFS that were not really being resolved that made EXT3 a considerably better choice, and the fact that they probably weren't going to be resolved. ReiserFS has a small and shrinking development community. Right now, the only developers really working on ReiserFS are Chris Mason, Jan Kara, the person we saw before, a rotating member of Hans Reiser's team, and myself. All of us have projects we're very much more interested in than working on ReiserFS. While Jan and I will continue working on ReiserFS for SUSE, Hans is increasingly, hard to believe, pushing people to use Reiser 4. Chris has moved on to Oracle and has expressed his opinions on leaving ReiserFS behind. ReiserFS 3 is a dead end. Hans has been pushing for Reiser 4 for years now and declared Reiser 3 in maintenance mode. Any changes that aren't bug fixes are met with violent resistance. Reiser 4 is not an incremental update and requires a reformat, which is unreasonable for most people. So yes, that is actually a key part as well. When we talk about ReiserFS, the ReiserFS that's merged into the kernel is ReiserFS 3. This basically was functionally complete except for all of the bugs that needed to be addressed. Reiser 4 is a separate thing. Here is an archive from 2005. Reiser 4 is released. It was released, but it wasn't in the kernel, and it wasn't anywhere near ready to replace Reiser 3. Also, you had to migrate file systems over, so that was going to be like a big issue as well. But it is what they were pushing towards, because this was being sponsored by the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, also known as DARPA. They don't endorse the project, but they did sponsor it. They're also being sponsored by Linspire, which is a name that many of you probably haven't heard in a very long time. This is a distro that is technically still around. Their latest release was December 18th, 2023, so you know, you could argue it's not still around anymore. Formerly known as Lindows, is a commercial operating system based on Debian and Ubuntu, owned by PC/OpenSystems LLC. It had been owned by Linspire Inc. from 2001 to 2008, and then by Zandros from 2008 to 2017. Now, the reason they are called Linspire and not Lindows is Microsoft was not exactly a fan of that and sued them in 2002, claiming the name Lindows constituted an infringement of their Windows trademark, which I think is fair to say considering what they were trying to be. They were trying to be a Windows-like Linux operating system. I see why Microsoft wasn't a fan of that. Also being sponsored by SUSE, as you would expect, considering that SUSE was also using Reiser, not 4, but Reiser 3 as their file system for a time. Now, whilst both versions of the project were started by Hans Reiser, obviously at a point it couldn't be continued by Hans Reiser. So there were people at Namesys who believed in the project, who thought this would be a good file system one day, who wanted to keep working on Riser 4. The project was mainly led by Edward Shishkin, who mentioned earlier. Now, a few years later, in 2010, there were attempts to make Riser 4 a mainline file system in the kernel. The issue is, without any corporate backing, it wasn't likely to find its way into the kernel because they already had one file system that had very little maintenance. They didn't need two of them. Both in the Pharonix comments and various other places, people were suggesting, hey, maybe it's not in good faith to keep using the Riser name for the file system. Maybe change the name and name it after his wife or something else. But that never happened. They kept using the Riser name. And eventually, in 2019, we saw the announcement of another version of ReiserFS, Riser 5, announced by the then-maintainer, Edward Shishkin. Now, most of the email is just technical reasons why ReiserFS is a thing, why Riser 5 is a new approach, and why it's a better approach than what they were doing. If you'd like to go and learn about the file system, there is a lot written here. A lot that I frankly just don't really care about for the context of this video. And it's still going. There we go. And whilst it was announced, it was pretty much in the same state. It was being developed by a couple of people. It didn't really have corporate backing. And maybe something will eventually happen to it, but fairly unlikely. In 2022, it did get a bit of coverage from Pharonix, Riser 5 issues, new development release, performance numbers for scaling out. And every time ReiserFS comes up, the first comment is, hey, did you know that Hans Reiser killed his wife? This person saying he should rename it to ShishkinFS from ReiserFS because Riser 5 is a work of Edward Shishkin. Honestly, of the reasons for a rename, I don't really think that's a bad one. He is the person who made it, but again, renames never happened. It's still Riser 5 today. Now, at this stage, there weren't any direct plans to remove ReiserFS from the kernel or even bring Riser 5 in, but it wasn't related to Hans Reiser himself. He hadn't been involved in the project for a really long time. The issue is it just didn't really have good maintenance. It kind of been left to rot. Nobody wanted to work on it. So it was kind of just there. No one was using it as well. Early on, yes, but years on from that, people had migrated over to other things. And the main issue is it suffers from 2038 bugs that are never going to be resolved because nobody wants to sit down and fix the bugs. So eventually, the file system was going to be bricked anyway, and it had to be removed. So when the 5.18 kernel released in 2022, it was marked as deprecated. But deprecated obviously doesn't mean removed. It just means, hey, we're gonna remove this eventually. We don't know when, but one day. Then in 6.6 in 2023, it went from supported to obsolete. So it's deprecated, and now it's double deprecated. Now, this happened in mid-2023, and in response to the deprecation notice, someone decided to go and actually reach out to Hans Reiser in prison, sending him a letter, and just seeing what he feels about this happening. This was sent to the mailing list on January 18th. Now, a lot of the letter is focusing on his time working in the kernel, some interactions he had, things he could have done better, and, you know, just generally feeling remorseful for what he's done over the years. But there's a few things I do want to focus on. Firstly is his final request. Assuming the decision is to remove V3 from the kernel, that being ReiserFS V3, I have just one request, that for one last release, the readme to be edited to add Mikhail Gilula, Konstantin Shevako, and Anatoly Punchuk. I have no idea how to pronounce these names to the credits. Incidentally, anything in there I might have said about why they were not credited it is time to let go. In prison, I've been working quite hard on developing my social skills, especially my conflict resolution and conflict avoidance skills. There is a lot of conflict in prison, as you can imagine, and is quite a good place to learn those skills. Nothing like lots of practice and the groups they let us take if we want to have quite a well-developed curriculum. Repetition helps, at least for me. It has changed me. One of my dreams is to someday convince the state legislature to teach the curriculum they teach us prisoners in elementary school, that people like me can learn it better without having to go to prison to learn it. I'm trying to convince some people to pitch it to legislators. If anyone would like to help with that, please let me know. It will help with more than just avoiding prison, it will help with all relationship conflicts, and who does not have those? And the final statement, I wish I'd learned the things I'd been learning in prison about talking through problems and believing I can talk through problems and doing it before I'd married or joined the LKML. I hope that day when they teach these things in elementary school comes. I thank Richard Stallman for his inspiration, software, and great sacrifices. It has been an honor to be of even passing value to the users of Linux. I wish you all well. And maybe you're surprised by this, but that request did actually get implemented back in the 6.10 kernel. There was a lot of stuff in here, basically just ragging on people that were working on the project and why they shouldn't have been credited, and all of that has now been removed. And now basically just saying, yeah, they did work in the early days. Yeah, they did good work. That's all that needs to be said here. And look who did the change. Jan Kara, the same person we saw at the start of the video, and we also saw way back in the early days when Sousa was considering dropping ReiserFS, or not considering, actually did drop it. At this point, I would be very surprised if there are any users still reliant on ReiserFS. Most distros haven't really made it easily available in a very long time. If you want to use ReiserFS, you've had to go and use FSCK and manually set it up. So if you're doing like an Arch install, I guess you could do it, or you manually go out of your way with something like Ubuntu and set it up, but I really doubt there are that many people affected. If you are affected, please let me know down below and let me know why you have a system using ReiserFS. I would assume it's just a legacy system that's never been migrated over to something new, but if there is a reason why you still use it, I would really love to know. And on that note, that is the end of the video. So let me know your thoughts down below. Do you think ReiserFS should have been dropped a long time ago? Are you surprised there was anyone even remotely still maintaining it, even just a tiny little bit? I'd love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, Libero Pay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and being mean is not as bad as killing someone. There's my hot take for the day. Like this.